do a little follow-up here to the city council's approval of putting a big apartment house right next to this one. Same guy applied. 156 more units coming in right here. They have to post an application. See any posting out here of any public notice of project being considered, so they know to come to the city council meetings where it's going to be discussed. No public posting there. 156 units is huge. It's going to probably be as big as this building right here. I think the public deserves to have a say about that. I don't know how much, but here's what they did. Property goes all the way back through to Grand here. And then how about this? This is Hope Street over here. They're calling it the Hope Apartments, just like it, make it sound like it's just one little apartment house. Put the public notice on the back side. How deceiving is that? How many people are going by the back of this property to monitor when the next project's gonna get built here? That's just so deceiving. Of course, nothing for sale, just rentals only, so the corporate rich guys who build this end up getting even richer. They're renting two bedrooms in this building for $4,500 a month, which sounds more like a hotel. In fact, you can stay in a hotel cheaper than that. This extended stay is cheaper than that, $150 a night. But that's what it's coming to. They're just going to keep building out apartments everywhere the way it looks. This will all be the same four-story like this one. And just be these big stucco monsters everywhere. And not really doing much for the regular people, because it's just going to be rich people renting them. It's all going to be gone there. So yeah, how do you feel about the notice being on the backside? The city posted that. They're in cahoots with them. There it is. That was the only notice. Hope you saw it. It bugs me that the city council bragging to the Union Tribune that no one objected to this project. Yeah, no wonder, huh? Sheesh. Going down on the south side of Carlsbad Village Drive. They already have this one built back when 2 and 3 story was the limit. Somehow that's not the limit anymore. But it makes you wonder how much longer before the church gets made an offer they can't refuse, because they have about a half a block's worth here. A prime real estate. Someone will come in, do the same thing. 4-story, 5-story, and it'll just end up continuing all the way down the road and into the nearby areas. Poyos Maria's just went out, sold out. Can't imagine these two or three here, two plus the church. Poyos Maria, done, sold out. It's all going to end up getting max treatment by the city. They're going to want to put in 5-story apartments everywhere. Crying shame, really. And yeah, they insist on low-income housing, but it's just the absolute minimum. Like out of that 156 units, it was like 20 low-income. The rest are just for the developer to get rich on. I'm Jim the Realtor. Tack this on. It's going in with a couple hundred units over here. 5-story buildings. It's going to be like the Grand Canyon of apartments right here. You'd be coming in here, just be Stucco Valley. 480 units total between 5-story buildings on this side.
And all of this now going to be covered. And literally two developers making a killing.
At least they put the card on the front side here, huh? Go with that graffiti.
Nice.
they think 7-Eleven's gonna stay. So.